Hello viewers, welcome to Elimu TV, whereby we are going to learn and experience together. We are going to have our biology form 2 lesson 22, whereby your tutor will be me, Mr. Gerard. We are going to handle the topic on gaseous exchange under the subtopic gaseous exchange in a fish. So here we are going to deal we are going to be specific on the fish. We're going to have the following lesson goals, whereby by the end of the lesson, you should be able to describe the gaseous exchange in a fish. So let us be keen and follow up the lesson. You are welcome. We are now going to have a deeper description of the gaseous exchange in a fish. And as you're aware that fish live in water that contains oxygen and other dissolved gases. The breathing system of a bony fish consists of the mouth, the buccal cavity. We have the mouth, the buccal cavity, the gills, the opercular cavity, and also the operculum. As we can see the diagram on our screen, the gills consist of a gill bar, the gill filaments, and also the gill rectus, whereby we can see the gill bar or the grill, the gill arc, is a long curved bony structure, as you can see from our diagram, which provides a service area for the attachment of the gill rectus and the gill filaments. Gill filaments, they are numerous and long to provide a large service area for gaseous exchange. As you can see from our diagram, they are very long, and this is to provide a large service area for gaseous exchange. They trail in water and are covered by a thin epithelium that shortens the distance to be covered by respiratory gases. The gill filaments are supplied with a dense network of blood capillaries for the transport of respiratory gases. Arising from the other side of the gill bar, let me show you the gill bar. Arising from the other sides of the gill bar, facing the mouth, are the gill rectus. These are teeth-like structures that are pointed to trap all filter solid particles present in water. The gill rectus normally prevent solid particles from reaching the dedicated filaments, so as to protect them from mechanical damage. A larger plate known as the operculum protects the gills on either side of the head. The operculum is this side which is protecting the gills. It protects because on the other side that we are not seeing from the screen, we have also the gills. So they are being protected by what we call the operculum. Now we are going to have to see on the mechanism of gaseous exchange, especially in a bony fish. The mechanism of gaseous exchange, especially in the bony fish. And as I will be explaining, I require you to follow this diagrammatic representation over here, whereby in our diagram, we are having both the inhalation and exhalation. So I'm going to explain what you're observing from our diagram. The flow of the mouth cavity is lowered by muscular contraction during inhalation. Lowering of the flow of the mouth increases the volume of the mouth cavity but reduces the pressure. As a result, water flows into the mouth through the open cavity, while each closed operculum on either side of the mouth bulges outwards to cause reduction of pressure in the gill cavity, so that water containing dissolved oxygen then flows from the mouth cavity to the gill chamber over the gills. When all this is happening, the higher external pressure presses the flexible free edges of each operculum against the side of the mouth of the fish. Each operculum in this case acts as a valve to ensure that water enters only through the mouth. The mouth then closes and muscles raise the flow of the mouth cavity. This forces the remaining water in the mouth to flow towards the gill chamber. Remember, we are explaining the mechanism of the gaseous exchange or in the gills of a bony fish, and the reason here why we are using the water is because the gases, they are dissolved in the water that the fish is taking inside. So the water entering the mouth has a higher concentration of oxygen than in the gill filaments. Due to this difference, oxygen diffuses from the water flowing over the gills in the blood through the thin walls of the blood capillaries. The oxygen absorbed then combines with hemoglobin in the blood of the fish and is then transported to all parts of the body. On the other hand, the carbon dioxide concentration in the blood capillaries of the gill filaments is higher than that in water. The difference causes carbon dioxide to diffuse out of the blood into the flowing water through the walls of the blood capillaries. To facilitate maximum gaseous exchange between water flowing over the gills and the blood in the gills, a steep concentration gradient must be maintained across the respiratory surface. To achieve this, water and blood flow in opposite directions within the respiratory surface. This scenario is normally known as the countercurrent flow system. As the movement of blood and water continues in opposite directions within the respiratory surface, oxygen diffuses out of the water into the blood and carbon dioxide from blood into the water. By the time the blood leaves the respiratory surface, it has as much oxygen as the water. This is so because as water moves along, less and less oxygen diffuses out of it as blood and becomes more and more concentrated with oxygen. So that is just a brief explanation of the mechanism of gaseous exchange in the gills of a bony fish. Having done and said that, you can have the following activity whereby you are required to describe the mechanisms of the gaseous exchange in the gills of a bony fish. For more information on the lesson, you can refer to KLB Secondary Biology Students Book 2, which is the 4th edition Nairobi Kenya Literature Bureau. You can, to get this lesson and more of our lessons, you can send us an SMS to the number that is appearing on our screen, or you subscribe to our YouTube channel, which is Elimu TV, or our Facebook page, which also is Elimu TV, or you tweet us at Elimu TV _Kenya. Thank you, and let us subscribe so that we might get more of these lessons. You will be welcome.